In this lesson, we'll explore how to choose a layout tool on Editor X. Grid, Layouter, and Repeater are tools that help us arrange, align, and distribute space among elements in responsive design. We'll be diving into each one to see how they work, plus we'll discover when and why they're used. First up, the grid. The grid is an advanced layouting tool based on a two-dimensional framework and is made up of columns and rows. After you set up the grid and place an element inside the grid area, the element gets arranged according to the columns and rows. You can also position the elements differently within the same layout to suit your design. By default, on Editor X, every section contains a 1x1 grid. So, when you add an element to a blank section, like here, the image positions itself according to the entire section. Now, we'll adjust the grid layout to divide it into multiple grid cells. You can choose different grid layouts from the menu, or customize the columns and rows to best suit your design. When you place an element inside the grid area, the element gets arranged according to the grid cells. You can also choose to position the elements differently within the same layout. Elements can occupy part of the cell, the entire cell, multiple cells, and overlapping cells, giving you endless possibilities to work with. Grid is usually the best option for creating precise, pixel-perfect layouts, because you can build individual column and row definitions using units of measurement to control the grid structure at each breakpoint and position the elements accordingly. You can also set different grid properties and create different layouts per breakpoint to ensure that the design looks perfect on every screen size. For example, you can change the number of columns and rows in the grid at each breakpoint. Next up, let's explore the layouter. So while the grid has a two-dimensional layout, the layouter is based on Flexbox, which has a one-dimensional layout. It's a smart flex layout tool made up of responsive containers. A one-dimensional layout means it deals with one direction at a time, vertical or horizontal. We can also set the items to wrap and create multiple rows. Typically, item order is allocated from left to right as the numbers here show. The wrapping direction is set according to that too. Note that as the screen resizes, the items may shrink, and when an item doesn't fit in the available space in the row, it may wrap to the next row and create new rows. Since items align separately on each row, items may not line up, as the pink lines here show. Layouters are best for items with unique designs that may adjust in size and position as the viewport changes. Here, we've got the layouter mosaic display type, which has multiple rows, so items align separately to each row according to the content and screen size, regardless of how items are positioned on other rows. When you resize the screen, items may wrap automatically to the next row and also create a new row as the screen size changes. This only happens with a layouter and not with a grid. You can customize the layout by choosing from a variety of display types, including columns, rows, mosaics, bricks, slider, and slides. And you can choose how these items are displayed in relation to each other at each breakpoint. When we resize an item, it may affect the other items, including the container. This also happens when we reposition any items. Now, let's look at our third layouting tool, repeaters. Repeaters have multiple boxes containing dynamic content, so it's best to use a repeater when you want multiple items with the same design and layout, but different content. Any change to the design of one item in a repeater will affect all other items within it, which isn't the case for grids and layouters. Repeaters are also useful when you want to automatically populate a large number of items with content. This can be done by connecting to database collections. When you use a repeater, you can choose between different display types, including cards, list, slider, and grid cells. Plus, you can customize the layout display type per breakpoint. Okay, so now that we've gotten to know these three layouting tools, let's explore specific examples to explain when each tool works best. First up, let's break down this design to figure out which layouting tool to use for it. If we take a closer look, we can see that this design has different elements placed next to each other horizontally and vertically, plus some overlapping areas. Overlapping and working on a 2D framework are only possible with the grid, making it the right choice for this design. We can divide the section into columns and rows, and place the elements according to the grid cells. This means that we can also create the overlapping areas. As we resize the screen on desktop, the the design behaves responsively according to the grid properties we set. But on mobile or tablet, we may have to rearrange the grid layout to fit the design, as we did here. Let's consider the most efficient way to build this new design. Looking at it in more detail, we've got three boxes with questions and answers aligned vertically with gaps between them. They've got the same elements and layout, but different content. The perfect use case for a repeater. By using a repeater, we designed one item and positioned the elements. We also adjusted the grid of the item to precisely position the questions and answers. The layout changes in one item are automatically reflected in the other items, so we don't have to build each one separately just to update the content. And as we resize the screen, the repeater behaves responsively, according to the properties we set for it and the elements inside. But what if we wanted to build a design like these tags with different content and different colors? On closer inspection, we can see that the elements aren't aligning between rows. Plus, we also want the items to automatically wrap once the screen resizes. The Bricks Layouter works best here because it fits all these criteria. When we resize the canvas, we can see that the items automatically wrap nicely as the screen size changes. In some cases, different layouting tools can work, but whatever you choose will affect the design's responsive behavior and the setup. Here's a design where you could use either a grid or a layouter. Let's see why the layouter fits. We've got five boxes with gaps between them separated into two rows. If we choose to build it with a layouter, the elements will automatically adjust to every screen size. Let's check out that process first. Here's the design on the editor. We set the properties for each item, created gaps between them, and according to property set, the items automatically wrap to fit the screen size, even while staying on the same breakpoint. We can also set, for example, on mobile, the layout to something more interactive, like a slider. This can be done on repeaters as well, but not grid. Now, let's take a look at how we can build this design using grid. When we add virtual lines to the borders of the elements, this structure reminds us of a grid with columns and rows. We've got this two-dimensional layout of columns and rows, and we can get that precise element placement using the grid cells. The differences between this design structure with the grid and the one with the layouter are the responsive behavior and the setup. With the grid, the elements won't wrap automatically, but we are able to fully customize the grid layout manually per breakpoint, just as we did here for mobile. To recap, repeaters are best for designs with a repetitive layout, multiple items, and different content within each item. Go with layouters for items with unique designs that may adjust in size and position as the viewport changes. With layouters and repeaters, you can also set the layout to interactive layouts like sliders. And finally, grids are ideal for precise, pixel-perfect designs with distinct layouts at each breakpoint. Editor X is an advanced creation platform. To master it, continue watching this series of video tutorials.